I'm excited because I have a brand new Nikon D7000. It's awesome. And I'm going to give you a hands-on review. I'm not going to do the kind of review where the lab tests and all that kind of stuff. Basically, not because I don't want to, but because I don't have the equipment to do that. So what I can do is give you my impressions as a professional wedding photographer and portrait photographer as to what I think about the Nikon. The new Nikon D7000. I guess I must have Canon on my mind. Do you know why I have Canon on my mind? I'll tell you why I have Canon on my mind. Because I'm doing a review of the Nikon, but where's the camera? Right now, you're watching the movie mode of the camera, the Nikon D7000. And when I snap my fingers, we're going to be switching over to the Canon T2i, where I will actually be able to hold the Nikon D7000 in my hot little hands and show you what I think about it, okay? But right now, what you're watching, the video you're watching, is done on the Nikon D7000. I have the focus mode set to manual, so you don't see it moving around. I have the exposure mode set to automatic. I did a custom white balance. And I'm running a little lapel microphone. Okay, so that's what's going on in this particular portion of it. All right, now when I snap my fingers, we're going to switch over to the Canon T2i, and I'll be able to show you some things on the Nikon. All right, ready? You ready? Here we go. I'm back, and this time I'm holding the Nikon in my hand. This is the Nikon D7000. Excuse me one second, as these 50-year-old eyes need a pair of glasses to see. Ah, I can see you better. All right, let's do a little bit of a tour through the D7000. And let's start off right away by me making the proclamation. This is a very awesome camera. Very awesome. They've taken their movie game and they moved it right up near the top. It does the high definition 1080p at 24 frames per second. The Canon will go to 30 frames per second. This one will not, unless you dropped down the resolution. Does it make a difference? Well, what you're watching right now is the T2i, which is the same system that's in the 7D on the Canon side. And this one, in my opinion, equals the movie mode. So movie mode has, bing, has come right up in line with the Canon. It doesn't have exactly as many features as you would like it to have. In other words, it doesn't have the 30p, but below the 30p, the 24p, and when you drop the resolution down, it's got them all in there. As a matter of fact, sorry, if I want me to read them off to you, I can do that. I can go in the menu. I can go over to movie mode, video mode, and pop it down. The 1080p, which is 1920 by 1080 at 24 frames per second. That is the highest that you can go, okay? Then you've got 1920 by 80 at 24 frames normal quality. The beginning of this was the high quality one, so that you know. Then you have the 1280 by 720, which is 720p at 30 frames per second, at 24 frames per second, at high quality, normal quality. And then you have it at 30 frames per second and 24 frames per second, and you have 640 by 424 at 30 frames per second high quality. All right, what else it has is the Nikon D7000 is the first one that has automatic focusing. Now, I've used it, and my opinion of it is it's not there yet. It's not cooked quite yet. Now, what you can do is if you do videos and you do clips, all right, with the Canon, which is the one you're watching now, with the Canon, you're going to have to set it up, do your 10 or 15 seconds or 30 seconds, okay? Then you're going to stop. You're going to go to the next thing that you want to videotape. You're going to have to hand focus again or do the focusing that's built into the camera. When it locks in, start taping again. All right, this will help you because you don't have to break your stride. It has face recognition as one of the focus features. Okay, so if I'm shooting somebody here, I can let it get in. It doesn't go in that quickly, but pretty quickly, okay? And it'll stay locked on to that facial recognition system, and you can take your videos, your 10, 15, 30, 40 seconds, whatever it is that you want to do. Then you can swing over to the kid on the floor or your son sitting over in the chair that's trying to do a juggling act or something, and it'll lock in on his face and pull in the automatic focusing. And when you get this into something like Sony Vegas or Final Cut or iMovie, you can trim off those center sections. So it'll help you so that you don't break your stride. This is for someone that is trying to make something like for YouTube where you want it to be a little slicker. If you're gonna be doing just home movies, what do you care if you're watching it trying to grab the focus, okay? It isn't that bad at all. Where it is bad, and it differs from a camcorder, is this. Sometimes it'll lock off of what you want it to do. It'll come out of the focus and then come right back in. So you're watching this in and out, in and out, in and out, in and out. Does it sound bad when I'm saying it? It's bad when you're watching it, okay? But it's better than anything else on the market other than a camcorder. But the point is, with this, you get beautiful blurred backgrounds. It looks very professional. Look at the blurred background that we've got going here. It's much more professional looking than if everything was in perfect focus, which would look like a handy dandy camcorder that you can take at home. All right, now let's get back to the camera because there's a few things I want to tell you about. What it does right, it focuses very, very well. Better than the T2i Canon, better than the 7D, and yes, I owned a 7D for 2 months. Is it as good as the Canon, the Nikon D700? No, it's not quite as good as that, but it's not that far off. All right, so you've got something good going on here. You could actually use this as a main wedding camera if you're a wedding photographer. And if you're a hobbyist, you've got a high quality camera with this camera. It's got two card slots, so you can put two cards in there. One can shoot RAW, the other one can shoot JPEG, or you can have it flow over one into the other. Okay, so it's got that. It has got features coming out the wazoo. If anybody knows where your wazoo is, please write me an email and tell me. But anyway, I can set this camera up very, very well to my liking. I mean, it's got almost the same feature set as the D700. There is some glaring things wrong with the camera. Okay, so now that I sung its praises, oh, one more thing. One of the most important things that a few years ago, the first thing we wanted to do was we wanted to know, how's the high ISO? Awesome! 16 megapixels at ISO 3200 is no problem on this camera. None at all. Can it focus in low light? Yes, it can. As well as the D700? Not quite, but much better than the D90. Okay, much better than the D90. This camera is getting close to, if not, on a professional level, okay? So where are the problems? There's a few problems that are a little bit nitpicky, okay? They're nitpicky, but come on, Nikon, you sat there and you combed this camera over so well. How come you've got some of these little problems? One of them is when you're reviewing an image and the image comes back on the back of the camera, okay, on the D700, the D300, okay, all you have to do is push the center OK button and it zooms right in 100%. It's a setting that you can choose, 100% on your focus point. So you could be taking a picture, shoot, 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 ka-click, 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 ka-click. I also do sound effects, okay, because I'm a one-man show, all right? Then you look at it, you push the center button, you see it 100%. Is it on this camera? No, it's not. Why? There's a feature in here that addresses the center set button in the back here. But they only give you two choices, where it'll take the focus point and put it back to the center. Okay, well, my D3X and my D3 does that too, okay? But once I'm in the play mode, if I press the center button, it automatically, bam, gives me a 100%. So that is glaringly missing. It has a feature when you're looking at an image and you click the center button. You can now do all kinds of interesting things. Let me take it out of this. I'm looking at this and I click the center set button. Now I can watch and do conversion from RAW. I can edit the picture and stuff like that. Well, that's all well and good. And that is more of a lower non-professional level. And maybe it needs to be there for this camera. And it is there. So I'm not going to take that away. Okay, what I'm going to say is on that one menu part where it says the setup for the center button right here, all they had to do was add to zoom in to the focus point, the current focus point. Wow, how hard would that be to do? Okay, so bam, the camera gets a slam for that, okay? Doesn't make it a bad camera. Would I buy it? Well, I paid for this one, okay? This is my baby. I've been waiting for this camera. I have another peeve that I want to share with you, and it is just as important. Right now, you're watching me. I am talking to you on a wireless lavalier microphone. Other people will put a microphone on the top, and you think I'm going to the automatic gain control, don't you? But I'm not, okay? On the side here is the plug. Where you plug, I would have the plugs I could show you, but right now I'm using it on the camera that's recording. You plug the plug right in here. There's a microphone plug-in plug on this camera. This camera has more features that surprise me for the price on this camera. It's amazing. However, in its wisdom, Nikon took the plug and did not center it in the hole. So you take this little, it's a waterproof little cap. You open the cap and the plug is in there for the microphone. So it's a stereo plug. However, this lavalier mic and the, let's say the Rode shotgun mic, or if you want to add one of the other units to this, it's going to go from mono to stereo. So you're going to run out to Radio Shack or one of your electronics store and you're going to get the adapter. Okay, this plug here is not centered in its hole. You can't see it, but trust me, when I plug in my receiver for the microphone, when I plug it in here, okay, and it has to go in the adapter, it is off center enough where it keeps popping out and I lose my right channel. What's that about? Halfway through a video, you're gonna find out that your sound is not there on one of your channels. How crazy is that? Is it a deal breaker? No, I really, really like this camera a lot. Is it a crazy build mistake? Yes, it's a crazy build mistake. What happens, what I gotta do is I've gotta plug it in, I've gotta get a big old rubber band and go around the whole camera and tie it in with that so that it gives it an inward pressure all the time. That doesn't look very nice, okay? But if I don't do that, halfway through a video, it could just pop out. All that, it goes in enough just so it captures the left and the right channel, but it's out enough so that if we had a little tremor in this room, I'm not talking about earthquake tremor, you know, I'm just talking about natural pressure, it'll just slide right out, okay? That's a crazy design feature. I'm talking about a standard adapter that you would get at a Radio Shack store or your local electronics store that's from a mono plug to a stereo plug so that you can get sound on the left and the right channel, okay? When you use that, because this is off-centered enough, okay, it makes it an issue, something that should not be an issue. Those are my two major corrections that I would have to make on the camera. High ISO, I'm a high ISO nut, okay? I shoot at ISO 1600, 3200, all right? This camera has no problem there. That's a major statement coming from just 4 years ago. When Nikon, or 5 years ago, the D200 was crappy at ISO 800 and higher. Now I'm telling you, I can shoot at ISO 3200 with a D90 upgrade, okay? So this is the D7000. This is almost on professional level quality camera. It's got water, I don't want to say waterproof, weather water resistance, okay? It's got a magnesium build, it's got the two card slots, it's got more features than Carter has liver pills, except for that one where you push the button and you can get an instant 100%. What's that about? That can be fixed in a firmware. They cannot fix moving this in a firmware, okay? That hole should have been in the center of this, where it's recessed in here. But because it's so far over to one side, a standard Radio Shack adapter won't work. What I'm gonna do is go back to Radio Shack and see if they make like an extender so it's not so wide when you plug it in here, but now we're gonna be adding distance and length, which could add more noise. That didn't need to happen. It's not a deal breaker. I love this camera. I really like the camera. Nikon did a great, great job. It's a knockout. It's an absolute knockout. The features on the camera, the LCD is gorgeous. The viewfinder, something that I didn't mention on the positive side, the viewfinder is awesome. Great low light, focuses in low light, the dual card slots, all right, they're SD instead of a CF. Maybe the D300 upgrade will have dual CF cards, I don't know. Okay, so I gotta give this camera a big thumbs up with those two major reservations, which I bet you didn't see coming. You didn't see those coming, did you? I hope I'm mistaken on this, but I could tell you I have gone through the book. And let me tell you one more little feature that you're gonna laugh at me, okay? When I got this camera, all right, I wanted to switch it from where it selects the focus points to where I can select the focus points with the little adapter on the back, not the adapter, the controller on the back, up, down, left, right, and I can move through my 39 focus points, which, by the way, the outside focus points work better than I expect. At a camera at this price level, they work better than I expect on all, even the upper level cameras, my D3X and this on the outer peripheral focus points, very close, okay? So we're talking some very good focus abilities here. Okay, now, how do you think you switch from automatic focus mode to where you select the focus points? So you're gonna look on the back and you're gonna see this thing here that's got that kind of a look to it. Does it do it? No, doesn't do it. You're gonna look up on the top. It's got a button with a center button and four other buttons that might make it so you can select a focus point. Does it do it? Nope, doesn't do it. Any combination of buttons, does it do it? Nope. Is it in the menu? Look everywhere through the menu. Okay, I know cameras, guys. I mean, I almost buy every camera that comes out. Is it in the dial up here? It's got an upper and a lower dial? Nope. Where the heck is it to get it out of the automatic focus selection section? I called a friend of mine that's got a D90, and he's even purchased the new D3100. How do you take it out? Nope, not on this camera. Can you believe I finally had to go and open the instruction book? Okay, now you're laughing at me because some of you guys go like, yeah, well, I read the instruction book too. But come on, something like that? I should be able to do that with my 30, 40 years of experience with this stuff just like that, if I could snap my fingers, right? I couldn't do it. Do you know where it is? Let me show you where it is. I mean, I looked up underneath, I looked on the sides, I looked everywhere. Nowhere you would have expected, okay? Over here, there's a button that says automatic focus, manual focus. You guys that have Nikons are all familiar with it. The D3, the D3X, the D700 has got three choices here, continuous, okay, manual and autofocus, all right? This one's got a left and a right, and it's got a center button, okay? I thought that center button was a lock release, but it's not a lock release. When you press and hold this button here, and you turn this dial up here, and you look in this LCD up here, you can change it so that it is in the different focus modes, from automatic, where it automatically selects the focus points, or you can change it to where it's a single focus point, or you can change it to where it's one of the others, which they allow you to cut down from the 39. Clumsy, but it really got my goat that I couldn't find that. That was amazing. That was a good job, Nikon. If we were playing hide and seek, you would have won on that one, okay? That's the only other thing that I wanted to tell you about the camera. I'm gonna come back and tell you more after you've had time to regurgitate this. I know I'm talking fast. I'm trying to keep it condensed, okay, so that you don't have to sit there and watch a long period of time to see an opening round, because there's a lot of people that really want to know, well, hey, what's up with the D7000? Thumbs up or thumbs down? Thumbs up, baby. This sucker is excellent. It's a wonderful camera. It competes and betters the D300, in my opinion. It competes and betters the Canon 7D, in my opinion. Okay, excellent, excellent camera. I give it a huge thumbs up. Peter Gregg from Miami, Florida. I'll catch you again. Take care. Bye-bye.